In the energy quadrant today, crude oil actually down 6% on the lows, finishing the day closer to down 5%. We're moving further and further away as we extend lower from that gap fill, which is a technical signal where when you get a gap open, which we had 4 days ago in the crude oil, a gap lower from the previous day's settle. Technically, people look for that gap to fill, and we're moving further and further away from that now. The technical gap definition means it eventually has to fill. It's not necessarily something that happens today, tomorrow, next week. Could happen a year from now, and technicians would say that the gap has filled. But we're moving further away from there now as we extend lower. Gasoline futures actually took a pretty big hit today, and that's interesting because when you look at what happened to gasoline futures, it was not tracking with crude oil futures. And a lot of people were questioning why. There was always a catch-up if the crude oil move sustained where it was. We saw the big build yesterday in the EIA figures. We're going to start seeing that in gasoline as well. But on top of that, it's forced demand destruction that we're seeing here. It's not a little bit of demand destruction by people who might not go on vacation. There's building closings. The NBA has suspended the season. The NHL has suspended the season. Flights are being canceled. Trips are being canceled. People are not driving to the airport. Taxis and Ubers and Lyfts are not driving people to destinations. So this is actually forced demand destruction by this virus. So it's actually something that hits the gasoline market as a secondary effect to the crude market. So you're likely to see them both move up in tandem if and when this thing recovers. We hope it's going to recover, but you'll need to see some of these things turn around in terms of closures and banning of large gatherings for that to happen.